Most people pour 2 or 3 inches of floor screed. I poured 8. Yeah, 8 inches of semi-dry screed. Sounds crazy? Let me show you why it actually makes perfect sense. This isn't just a floor. It's a thermal battery and a key part of my home's energy system. Underneath the concrete, I place 8 inches of insulation. That's right, 8 inches of foam insulation to make sure heat doesn't escape down into the ground. It stays where I want it, inside the house. Inside the slab, I installed both underfloor heating pipes and electric heating cable. This way, I can heat it using hot water, electricity, or even solar power, depending on the season and the energy source available. And here's where it gets really smart. I designed this house with large, south-facing windows. In winter, the low sun shines directly through those windows and warms the floor during the day naturally. That solar heat gets absorbed by the thick concrete mass. And slowly, throughout the evening and night, it releases that warmth back into the room. No batteries, no fuel, just physics. Later on, I'm going to add solar panels. On sunny days, I'll send excess power into the electric heating cable. So even on cold nights, this 8-inch slab will radiate heat, and I won't have to burn anything. Now, I know what some people are going to say. Semi-dry screed doesn't conduct heat as well as wet concrete. That's true. It has lower thermal conductivity. But here's the thing. I'm not trying to heat the floor quickly. I'm trying to store heat and release it slowly over time. And for that, thermal mass is way more important than thermal conductivity. With 8 inches of solid concrete and 8 inches of insulation underneath, the heat stays exactly where it's needed in the living space. Pouring it wasn't easy. I used a semi-dry mix sand, cement, a bit of water, and fibers. It was pumped in, leveled, compacted, and then smoothed out with a power trowel. Some areas will get tiles, others will have laminate. But either way, the foundation is strong, quiet, and warm. Look, I know this isn't the standard way to build a floor, but I'm not building a standard house. I'm building a home that's smart, efficient, and prepared for the future. If you want to see how to build not just faster, but smarter, follow along. I'm sharing everything I learned, wins, mistakes, and all. Do you build a floor like this? Drop your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more DIY building ideas.
for the ottomans.